Loop is famous for its hustle and bustle, its gorgeous architecture, and the financial hub of our fair city. It's not necessarily known for its food and cocktail scene, however. Fortunately, Pearl Tavern is changing all that. Now, Pearl Tavern is located right in the heart of our business district, which fits perfectly because they mean serious business, especially when it comes to oysters, champagne, and craft cocktails. I'm about to sit down with the owner, Adolfo Garcia, to find out about his vision for this restaurant. Okay, first off, Adolfo, I just want to say congratulations.
Thank you.
On opening such a beautiful establishment. I mean, awesome. This is very, very special.
Thank you so much.
So happy to be here. And I just can't believe everything that you've accomplished in the several years you've been here since emigrating from Mexico. And I want to hear more about your journey.
I moved to Chicago in 96. I was waiting tables in a restaurant in a resort in Mexico. And I met this wonderful couple. And they said, you know, you can really do well back in Chicago. So, you know, I packed my bags and, you know, a week later, in 1996, I'm in this town. I never seen snow in my life.
That would be a shock.
Yeah, I don't know what below zero really even meant. You know, my Christmas were
Welcome
70s.
To Chicago.
And, you know, 2 weeks later, I was washing dishes. I was working kitchen. I was working a line cook, fryer, and that led to, you know, front of the house. Front of the house led to start bartending. Bartending led to, you know, meeting the girls. And then I met the love
Always
of my
important.
Life. And, you know, therefore, it was no going back to Mexico. And, you know, I ended up taking care of my issues back home and marrying the girl that I met. And we both opened our first place 4 years later in 2001. And here I am.
So it's safe to say you truly experienced the American dream.
Yes. If that is meeting the mother of my kids and do what I love, yes, that's the American dream for sure.
This decor is very sexy, but very gorgeous. It's so beautiful. And I know you were saying your inspiration was kind of like the 50s and 60s, but what other inspiration did you have to come up with this specific decor?
This is an incredible question. Thank you. I will put it in three different ways. Three things that I'm very passionate about it: music, food, and film. To find an element in food, well, the best era in the United States for oysters was precisely from the 40s to the 60s, you know, going from the cocktail bar to the supper club. You know, it was a center gathering social part. The oyster is as American as the flag, you know. So that those two elements were great, and, you know. And then the decor, well, I wanted to, you know, to keep the integrity of the saloon, keep the dark woods, you know. But then the colors, if you notice in the wallpapers, is very bright pinks, pastel colors, you got like sea horses, and that my inspiration was literally came from my favorite film director, one of the best American film directors that I can possibly think, at least personally, is Wes Anderson. He came across as like, if I do an oyster bar with like swanky 60 cocktails, I mean, what better film than, you know, I literally pictured Bill Murray with the background colors and the crazy music. And you know, you combine, you know, jazz, rock, you know, Wes Anderson and oysters, and you know, the baby boy is called Pearl Tavern, you know, baby girl.
I
you know,
that's love it.
That's the way that I put it, you know?
I love it. Well, I'm not sure if you know this, but I'm about to go have a little oyster 101 with your chef Matt.
Awesome.
And I'm gonna apparently learn a lot about oysters, and I'm also gonna shuck some oysters.
Oh my god, that's awesome.
So wish me luck.
And hopefully,
I've never done that before.
And I hope you find a pearl.
I hope so. That would be great. But I'm probably going to need a cocktail after that because we'll see how well it goes. So I will meet you for a cocktail after I learn how to shuck some oysters.
Absolutely.
Sound good?
Thank you.
Cheers again, Adolfo.
Salud. Thank you.
Thanks. All right, Chef. I like to think that I've been kind of an oyster expert for a long time. But meeting you, I find out that my knowledge is like this much, while yours is this much. So I need you to give me a lesson because I want to learn more. So what have we got going on here? Because there seems to be quite an array of oysters in front of us.
Well, we got an excellent oyster program here. It's focused on a higher quality. I think that's more important than quantity since we're here in the Midwest. I like to run one East Coast, one West Coast for lunch. and 2 and 2 for happy hour and dinner.
Interesting.
It just allows us to make sure we are constantly turning through our product, offering the customers the absolute freshest. None of our oysters last more than 24 hours.
All right, now comes the fun part that I've been very excited about.
Yeah,
we're gonna shuck some oysters.
We'll crack some open.
All right, what do I do now? I need to put on this little protective gear.
Yeah, we got our nice chainmail gloves, so the shell and the shucking knife.
Can we call it a Michael Jackson glove?
Yes, we can. I like to call it the Michael Jackson glove or the Game of Thrones glove. Nice.
Oh my
and
God,
protected.
Or Michael Jackson in the Game of Thrones glove.
Oh, that's a great combination right there. Could you imagine?
No. All right. Show me what to do. I'm ready.
All right, so we're going to crack open some oysters. We'll give an East Coast and a West Coast a try. I've got one of my favorites here. I'll crack open. This is going to be a old 1871.
Look how pretty that is and all the little other shells on the shell.
Oh, they're absolutely gorgeous oysters. These ones, the old 1871s, were created actually for Chicagoans. They're the quintessential Chicago oyster. You know, we like big buildings, big steaks, and big red wines. They took a West Coast oyster, brought it to the Virginia Barrier Islands, and cultivated it so it has East Coast flavors. It gets nice and deep and big. And this is our oyster right here, named
that
after the
cool.
Chicago Fire.
We don't even grow oysters here, and we've got our own.
Yes,
love
we
it.
Do.
All right, how do we open it?
I'm going to grab one for myself as well.
Okay.
So basically, you're going to find the hinge end, which is where the two shells connect. And you want to wiggle the knife right in there. Just wiggle the tip part in there, and you're just going to pop it open. Scoop.
All right, let me try this puppy.
Flip. Should be nice and clean.
The glove comes in handy for something. Yeah. That was delicious. Well, thank you. These are delicious and might have an injury, but that's okay. It was all in the name of delicious food.
Perfect.
Thanks. So, Adolfo, I just had quite the oyster lesson, but Pearl Tavern, of course, has more than just oysters. Your
Absolutely.
Food is spectacular, too. So, tell me about these dishes in front of us.
Okay, well, you know, part of our crudo bar, it's or ceviche. That's my old man's recipe.
Really?
So, yes, absolutely. So this is incredible.
All the way from Mexico.
All the way from Mexico. So we have a lot of Spanish, Italian influences in this dish, and most ceviches are curated with lime and citruses.
Okay.
In this case, we, you know, we use the seafood, fish, shrimp, whatever you choose. In our cases, it's a beautiful seasonal fish. So we curate it with lime only for about 5 minutes. And then we drain all the citrus out.
So the citrus doesn't overpower
exactly,
it.
Exactly,
okay.
Exactly.
I've never seen a lobster roll with lobster chunks that huge. That is unbelievable. How'd you come up with, like, basically having a whole lobster on a sandwich?
Correct. Well, we kind of went with the Connecticut style lobster roll. But again, this is real lobster. We're not chopping it, putting, you know, sauce, cream, etc. It's just poach. Butter, phenomenal in-house made bun, and we have the coleslaw on the side, so you can really get a good intake into what the real lobster is, which is natural flavors. You know, we don't have any, you know, we don't add any sauce or any creaminess to it. You know,
it's beautiful.
Thank
I mean,
you.
Cannot wait to eat that baby. All right, now I want to talk about some cocktails.
For sure.
Okay, these are gorgeous. Tell me about what's in each of these, because they all look very different.
All right, well, besides our traditional cocktail program, these are one of our in-house creations and one of my favorite ones. The first one is the Angry Mermaid, and I'm very passionate about mezcal. So this is our, you know, in-house mezcal with slow smoke habanero and make it into syrup.
Oh my God, that's so delicious.
Thank you, thank you.
It definitely has the heat.
Yes.
But the mezcal, the smokiness from the mezcal goes so well with the heat from the habanero.
Thank
wow.
you.
That's good. All right, what's next?
This is my personal favorite. So,
pretty.
You know, Chicago is a martini town, so everybody likes dirty martinis. And, you know, what makes a martini dirty is the little bit of the olive juice. In this case, we call it a dirty pearl. So it's, beautiful premium vodka. And we use the brine of the oysters, so it's the little juice with the oyster meat, and that's what makes it dirty. And then we put a East Coast oyster right on top of it.
Ooh,
so
Because the oysters that I was trying here, they were salty enough to definitely be able to flavor a martini. So that is beautiful. You know, but it's not too overpowering because a lot of dirty martinis can be too strong with the olive juice. And this is just like that perfect subtle saltiness. But
it's two of my favorite things, chilled vodka and oysters.
And that's a statement too, to have an oyster in a glass. It's almost like a meal in a glass. You can just snack with your drink. I love it.
Thank you.
I don't want to spill that.
Beautiful.
All right. I'm going to need to work my way through all three of those. Those are delicious.
Absolutely.
All right, Adolfo. Thank you so much. This, I mean, everything is absolutely gorgeous, from the unbelievable decor to the drinks to the food. And what I really want to know is, a little birdie told me that there might be a little surprise coming up with Pearl.
Absolutely.
Something coming down the line. Can you share that with me?
Absolutely.
Give me a little insight.
More than happy. With you, anything.
Oh, thank
absolutely.
You.
Well, Pearl Tavern, you know, Oyster Bar, I acquired the property right next door, and I wanted to marry something that had to do with sweets.
Okay.
And we're gonna do a Pearl Cafe, which is gonna be a beautiful barista coffee shop with beignets.
Basically, you can come to Pearl Tavern, have an oyster, have a very spicy cocktail, and then go next door and then kind of cool off your palate and your taste buds a little bit with some beignet.
Absolutely.
Love it.
Thank you.
Well, can't wait. I better be the first one to check it out.
You will.
All right. There's not many beignets in Chicago, so this is something really exciting.
Yes, folks. We're crazy about it.
Thanks.
Thank you so much.